symposium for the chance to speak here and present the results of our research. I represent one of the oldest orthopedic institutions on the CIS territory. This is Osipenko Center, founded in 1907. Today it is a state institution. Institute of Pathology of Spine and Joints of the Academy of Medical Sciences of Ukraine. Our topic is centering parameters of sagittal spinal and pelvic balance with patients. Vertical position of a person normally is characterized by harmonious balancing of the body above the pelvis at minimal muscular effort, which implies correlation between spinal and pelvic parameters of sagittal spinal and pelvic balance. The range of parameters of sagittal spinal pelvic balance and the position of sacrum in relation to gravitation is strictly determined. And besides change in position parameters of sagittal balance, GLL, the incline of sacrum SS, and horizontal position of pelvis PT, which is linked to degenerative diseases. Compensation which is reflected in the lower extremities. However, the link between the central parameters of sagittal balance and the joints of the lower extremities has not been studied a lot in different patients. The materials that we use in our research protocols of studies research in 30 asymptomatic volunteers aged 20 to 30 and 42 patients with degenerative diseases of lumbar spine. The criteria of inclusion of those patients and people, other people into study was absence of pain with volunteers, and with patients it was absence of neurologic disorders with paresis. Biomechanic observation in standing position stereographic platform included study position of some anthropometric volunteers. In relation to projection of рентгенографии of lumbar spine with femoral heads was conducted in sideways projection in standing position using a stereographic platform, and thus a patient got complete posture. And spondylogroup's defined parameters of sagittal spine pelvic balance, the incline of the upper surface of sacrum. Statistic research, the grand median, and the standard deviation, and assess the D criteria using student method, and the credibility was less than 0.05. The web mechanic research demonstrated that in the vertical position there are four types standing with respect to sagittal plane, and there are some differences in values. Even different types of posture. The first type of posture with volunteers was defined as mechanically ideal. This is a type of posture with pelvis. The average parameters of the sagittal balance can be seen on the slide, and the position of the sacrum related to the gravitation line was also measured. Now we will see the movement. That's what I said. We can see on the screen. And here you see the parameters that we studied, and these are the normal values. Seven slides like this. The second type of posture, unfortunately, we didn't see the slide with the first posture. The joints of the lower extremities were ideally positioned, but the lordosis values with patients, but more than that of volunteers. As for the second type of posture, volunteers demonstrated more than 50% of joints of lower extremities positions behind the gravitation line. The sacrum position with respect to gravitation line was normal, and the centers of femur heads were almost at the line, on the line of gravitation. The stabilization was carried out, was conducted in a more economic way. It is through tonic contraction of periarticular muscles. sacrum is a little bit further away from the gravitation line. The patients had a big percentage who showed the second posture type, which was 45.2%. The values of positioning parameters of sagittal spinal pelvic balance and SVA were lower than the norm. Volunteers and patients had different parameters of GLL and deviation of lumbar lordosis. The hip joints and knee joints were in front,
and
the deviation of the sacrum was within the norm, and the ankle joint was behind the gravitation line. These results cannot be used for statistics because this was not very large cohort observed. Patients had third type of posture in 23.9%. The patients who had lumbar osteochondrosis had normal morphological parameter VI and reversi of pelvis. Such patients had a trend of retroversion and hyperextension of the hip joints, and it was combined with relatively small depths of their lumbar lordosis. With fourth type of posture, the hip joint and the ankle joint was behind, and it was the most rare type of posture. Only one patient had it. And the lumbar lordosis with this type was significantly below the norm, and the deviation of sacrum from the gravitation line was also observed. And the vertical position of such patient is characterized by flattened sagittal turn of lumbar and sacrum part of the spine. It is a type of degenerative deformation, flat back. The horizontal inclination of the pelvis is increased.
Видно.
Here you can see that the sacrum is deviating, is gliding from the gravitation line. The straightening of the
orthosis,
which is flexive positioning of the
the
part of the body which is above pelvis and compensation retrograde of pelvis with extension positions and extension devices in hip joints create a rotation movement in lumbar sacral segment. Statistically, differences in parameters between different types of posture have not been found. The correlation between parameters of sagittal spinal pelvic balance is one of the conditions of biochemically ideal ergonomic logical posture. Various logical pelvic parameter PI characterizes vertical pelvis, which is the same as anteversy of pelvis. In our research, volunteers who had different types of posture, the values of sagittal balance, comprehensive, and in line with each other, but the patients had some compensatory mechanisms of sagittal recentering. However, as our research showed, some group of patients with the generative conditions of spine, with types of posture 3 and 4, had some absence of correlation between the values of sagittal spinal pelvic balance, and it led to compensatory changes in position of joints of the lower extremities. The change of sagittal centering parameters of sagittal spinal pelvic balance in patients with degenerative diseases is linked, in our opinion, not only to structural disorders in lumbar segments, but also with functional changes caused by antalgic muscular hypotonus. I thank you for your attention.
I'm delighted by the amount of work that you have done, but I have this impression that it was like a Sisyphus labor. Maybe I missed something, but because it's so much information. Could you kind of sum up like the purpose of your presentation? Well, we studied compensatory mechanisms of patients, and we saw which muscles become longer, which muscles shorten and contract, and we wanted to see what kind of functional treatment can be prescribed and recommended to patients depending on these failures. And I have this question. What for is it so? Well, it's for the improvement of treatment of patients who have degenerative conditions of their spine, like hernia.
All people
who have pain in their back have disorder of their position. I have more questions after your presentation than answers that you can give, but it is good. It gives us an incentive for further research. I am very glad that I got such a lot of questions. I just can't understand the purpose. Well, I tried to explain to you the purpose. Can I ask you a question? What is your specialty? Are you a surgeon, a practicing surgeon?
You know,
am I friend of an administration? Well, those specialists who practice rehabilitation, physiotherapy, they don't get this question, they don't have this question. Why do you do it and what do you need it for? Because they are interested in ways of getting rid of disorders in order to know how we need to study compensatory mechanisms. Well, I really did not understand all your presentation about, well, probably we speak different languages then. Okay, it's free, thanks. Thank you for your presentation, it was very interesting, and I got a question. You did research of sagittal balance. Did you observe the patients just from one side, right side or left side? And did you take into account asymmetry in the front plane? Asymmetries of pelvis. For example, did you come across such a case when you observe the patient from the other side, you got some other picture? Well, we had a unified way of observing patients. They were on the left side. Of course, we had some patients with kyphal scoliosis. But they didn't have this visible structural pelvic asymmetry that we could observe. When a patient had some twisting caused by hernia, for example, this is like functional, it was functional condition which can be eliminated. And we didn't work with those who had this permanent condition.
Last question, please.
Yes, один вопрос у меня.
У меня вопрос следующий. Насколько просто
in the clinical practice to define, to detect these parameters? This method that determines the anthropometric centers is quite easy. We have an anthropometric platform and it is connected to the computer. And this computer displays the various values on the screen, and they are recorded in the computer memory. The most important part is interpretation of data. And as well, rentgenometric observation is done, and a patient is placed on a platform. We do OCN projection, and in standing position, rentgenography is also done. It's a method which is common, and those were not us who developed it and described it. And also we measure linear distance. Surely measure the parameters of spinal and pelvic balance.
Thank you for discussion and answers.
Спасибо за дискуссию.
Scale VAS, the level of 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 the level
research being using scale TSK and to the level of insight. On a stable graphic platform in a convenient position.